It's really windy. Hello, welcome to Sunday Outside. Let's read your comments from last week. Last week's Sunday Outside was split into two parts. I don't know why. I don't know why it ran so long, but it did. It's so windy, but it's so funny. Elizabeth and me, Warren put, I can definitely relate to that sense of calm feeling recently too, Charlie. Great video. There's no sense of calm in this video. I really do feel like Dorothy. I don't think we're in Shepherd's Bush anymore. Raptor24GL's put, Sunderland, what's that? Is it a virus? I'm from Newcastle, Charlie. Smiley face. With a wink. Into owned Eldon Square and Metro Centre. Up this way. Metro Centre being the biggest shopping centre in Europe. Don't know why, but I had in my head, you didn't drink alcohol. I don't drink that much. I don't drink that much. Sudden inrush of light there. Look into the lights. Carolyn! Carolyn! It's because one of the flaps has blown up. The Velcro's come unstuck because it's that windy. That's quite a weird look, isn't it? Sunshine on a windy day makes my face. Oh, oh God, now I've just looked directly into the sun. Oh no, I've done a Donald Trump. Oh, can't see anything. Ah, that's better. Raptor24GL also put, on the plus side, plenty of vegan and world food products still available for those who want them. Exactly, it's because they don't eat. I'm joking. I know some of you are vegetarian and vegan and whatnot. If Into does go bust, the Metro Centre will still be open. That's definitely a shopping centre that'll get rebought, but I don't know about Eldon Square as much. That might be compulsory purchased by the council, and then they'll do whatever they see fit with it. But Uzi Chaz put, Corona a day keeps the virus away. Oh yeah, it's because I was drinking Corona last week as well, wasn't I? Maybe that's what slowed me down. Yeah, see, look. Alcohol not just slows your reactions down, but slows your Sunday outsides down as well. Sonia put, some people have no sense, Charlie. I had to go out to get some shopping. Not panic buying shopping, no. I'm better than that. There were signs up in the shops, 10 announcements too, to keep some distance apart from the person in front of you. And the staff telling the people too. I have common sense. Unfortunately, those are done and they're completely ignoring any advice they are given. I am glad I have common sense, Charlie, don't you? Pardon me. Exactly. And as the saying goes now, there's nothing more uncommon than common sense. I think that's the saying. And it's very windy. Very windy day. There's also three massive trees in this garden, so I could die at any moment. Ooh, suspense. I'm adding suspense to me on Sunday Outside videos. I charged my camera up last night on my phone. Completely forgot to do both of my tablets. I'm such an idiot. So I'm going to have to make sure I get through these in a reasonable amount of time. Next one is Sunday Outside, Raven Mad 2, Part 2. Part 2 of 2, where are they? Raptor24GL, they have pineapple Chewits now, Charlie, and they're pretty good. They're in Earn Bargains and Morrison's. You see, now that's to me sounding like an essential purchase. I need to... And Morrison's is miles away from me. Known Bargains is even further away. I think there's only one in London. Sonia's put, I will have a bottle of Corona with you, Charlie. I went to Boots the other day and staff member was at the door only allowing a certain amount of people in the shop at a time. You were also asked if you were going to the pharmacy or doing shopping. Never known anything quite like this. I know, because it is shocking how many daft people there are. I mean, we're just not obeying the sales assistant's orders, and if some people are more susceptible to getting poorly, then yeah. I will address a point that I did say it was all being overhyped, didn't I, a couple of weeks ago, and how it's all just been a blow out of proportion. I'm in perfectly good health, touch wood, as is all my family, touch wood. There's no wood in it. Unless the tree falls on my head, then I'm definitely touching wood. And the... But it's the media, because they've got so little to do now. They're just concentrating, and the fear, the people who are watching it until the eyes fall out the back of their head, watching the news 24/7, you need to stop it. I forgot to bring tissues. Oh, flipping heck. I knew I'd forgotten to bring something. There's going to be no tissue in these trousers. Oh, there is. There is. Oh, bit of blue roll. Good old blue roll. But yeah, I do think the media are definitely, obviously, helping people to be scared rather than precautious, and rather than being safe, because they're just constantly going on about it. They need to focus on the positives as well. They're not showing the people who survived very much. And if these people who survived, it's the people who've suffered from it the worst, if you know what I mean. So I'm still annoyed the way the media are handling all of this. I mean, I know they can't make it look like it's not too pointless, because obviously there's a lot of stupid people and think, oh, well, if they're all right, I'll be all right. You know what I mean? But, oh, is that too sad, isn't it? Raptor 24 Jails put, Charlie, I have been holding back, but all this continued discussion of opal fruits and Starburst can go on no longer without addressing the elephant in the room. Bring back Juicers! I love them so much. And I've been to an apartment from the USA to get the fix. I think I remember Juicers. I remember based in bugs. They were gorgeous. And Geek on Wheels has put, Marks and Spencer's fruit pastels are to die for, bags of joy. That's good to know, because usually shop's own brand stuff's usually rubbish, isn't it? Rebecca Trafford put, can you please do more videos? I did 10 videos this week, wasn't I? Busy, wasn't I? Chris Silver's put, or would Sunday Outside part 1 and 2 classes 1 video just split? Chris Silver's put, well, look like you won't be dragging your carcass out of bed to go to Mackie D's to get your double egg McMuffins now they've shut up shop. I know. I tell you what, though. You know, it was getting to the point where I was having my break in Mackie D's anyway. You know, when you get to that point where you're just having Mackie D's too much, then you stop going for a good while. I was getting to that point anyway. So I think the coronavirus shutdown is not really going to affect me that much. Next video is Monday Meander to do something ASMR peeling plastic. Oh yeah, I finally got round to peeling the plastic off the kitchen cabinets. Yes, I did. I'm going to press pause now because this has been a bit of a fuss. Ben Stocks has put, that thumbnail is amazing. Yeah, I've decided to keep that for these temporarily replaced Monday Meanders. It'll be on again tomorrow. I don't know what I'm going to do tomorrow. And Little Red Smith has put, proper made me laugh when you sang the word symptoms after coughing. I know. And Raptor 24 Jill put, they should bring back How Clean Is Your House with Charlie and Sherlock as Kim and Aggie. I loved How Clean Is Your House. Especially because there was both individual but both a pair at the same time, weren't they? So Kim was the more cleany side, whereas Aggie was more the scientificy sort of side. But they both did cleaning, and they was both involved sort of the scientifically sides of things, weren't they? Kim not so much, but they did work together. It was really good. And I just loved the way Kim used to shout, filth! And when Aggie used to just come up with these really long words. And sometimes the people on it wouldn't even care. So Aggie would say something, we tested this, and it's chlorosic. That will kill you in days, in seconds. In fact, it has killed me right now. And the people in there, whose house it was, like, alright. Yeah, because you don't want that lying around your house. Especially now. yeah, they should. I think that would be great. I think now would be a great time to bring it back, because I think heightened cleanliness, which I've been long saying, haven't I, that standards have been dropping for a while, needs to come back. I've still seen people spitting in the street. The dirty filth Muppets. Laura's put, no way, I thought you had just blue kitchen units. Absolutely flabbergasted. I love that word. Flabbergasted. I was flabbergasted. Also, white vinegar would help those smudges on the splashback. Yeah, I can't get any white vinegar anywhere, though. It's very irritating. And that's not just because of what's happening currently. It's just in general. Laura, Rebecca Jofford put, thank you, Charlie, for being amazing. I hope you're coping okay. I'm fine. I hope you are too. I hope all my subscribers are too. You're helping me get through this, and I'm sure, I hope that I'm helping relieve your boredom. Because we're all needing entertainment, aren't we, at the moment? But flipping heck, it's getting tough, isn't it? I mean, I've watched the entire run of Green Wing, Black Books, Peep Show. Have I even watched all of those? What else have I watched? Gimme, Gimme, Gimme. All over again. I mean, I'd already seen them all a bazillion amount of times anyway. Films and TVs getting really rubbish, isn't it? And Dex Saturday Night Takeaway. I liked, not the weekend just gone, this Saturday, just gone, but the week before when there was no audience. It was really good. Not listening to the audience squealing and screeching and screaming every 2 seconds. And clapping like, I don't know, seals on Red Bull and Monster. But yeah, it was nice. I didn't enjoy this Saturday just gone, this clip show malarkey. They could have still done it how they did it last week. They didn't need all the camera crew there. They could have had Ant and Dec operating the cameras on each other himself. Someone could have gone in during the week and set up all the cameras, social distancing. That'd have been great, wouldn't it? Hazelby's put, I still have protective plastic over my TV screen, lol. It is alright though, isn't it? As long as I've got no air bubbles in it. As soon as the air bubbles start creeping in, that's when it gets annoying. Honeybee put, oh wow, did not have a clue that you meant what you meant until I watched. Really satisfying to watch too. I don't think you should have removed the cooker splashback. I liked it, man. Yeah, you know, I'm starting to miss the white splashback, actually. The silver splashback. I'm having to get used to, even though it's been up there for quite a few years now. So Brandon Pictures has put, why did you leave the plastic on for so long? I'm sure it's been years since I saw that on your kitchen. It has been on there for years. It's because we didn't have the time or the money to get round to painting everything. And when we left it on, we didn't want the cabinets to get covered in paint or plaster or dust or anything like that. It was to keep it clean whilst the rest of the work got done. But that waiting for the rest of the work to get done took years, and you just sort of lived with it. It's getting used to the kitchen again, actually. It's weird not seeing blue in the kitchen. Although there's still a bit of blue around the fridge bit. It's only half the kitchen we've done, because that bit's done. I'm just wondering for Jill, but Charlie, I had no idea how much you used to look like Frank Skinner, picture one on the intro. Frank Skinner? Picture one. Oh, that was when I was at the thinnest, that. Yeah, that shirt that I'm wearing, it's long gone now, but there was absolutely no way I'd fit in that again. I had bone protrusion and everything. All the way across there, could see all this. So yeah, these are sticking out. I had like holes. I was practically just a skeleton with skin over me. I'll never get like that. I've gone into reasons why I'll never look like that again. No, it wasn't illegal drugs. Hazel B put, what is scrass? It's subscribe, comment, rate and share. Sonia's put, who would have thought that someone peeling off plastic off the kitchen cupboards and drawers could be so entertaining? It was because of you, Charlie. You should do a clean with me video now. I also love the thumbnail. The fourth picture is my favourite. You look so cute. Thank you very much. It was just something I just slung together. And quite a few people have commented on it. Am I getting a wet leg? Because I'm not too sure I've got the ground sheet on properly. I mean, trying to put a ground sheet down in a bazillion mile an hour wind was quite difficult. I'll just move my leg. next video was... the white chocolate cocoa pop buns. Oh, what a disaster that turned out to be. I didn't have no cases, did I? Yes, pause. 18 comments. Ooh, right. Geek on Wheels has put, all I can hear is Charlie crunching in the background, lol. Dave Dump has put, Charlie, have you run out of roses in London, lol? I know this. Never intended at all. This is definitely the longest it's ever been. Malaki Mason's put, no, you reviewed them on Saturday. Oh, yeah, it's because in the video I couldn't remember when I reviewed the actual Cocoa Pops, wasn't it? Jan Brands put, give it a good old smack, try the bad chocolate. Bad chocolate. Elizabeth Mewarren put, they look good. It was really, really nice, actually. They looked a mess, but they tasted amazing. And that's the main point, isn't it? I mean, I probably have Gordon Ramsay swearing at them and me a lot. But it tasted good. You know, don't look at them, just eat them. Don't look, just shove it in your mouth. Laura's put, hello, future YouTube. Honeybee's put, good lord, Charlie, you don't do things by half, do you? Three large slabs of chocolate. Next time, line a dish with greaseproof paper and pour it all in. One, I didn't have any greaseproof paper either. A pigeon has just pooed on my tent! I don't believe it! It's even running down the side as well! Look! I bet it was that pigeon! I can't look at that now for the rest of... And I don't want you to look at it either. Which way can I sit now? I don't believe that! Hey, I tell you what, it's a good job. I'm in a tent though, because normally I'd be stood outside, wouldn't I? I'd have had poo on my head. Now it's doing that, and it's going to smudge and smear. I'm sorry, YouTube. That is disgusting, isn't it? I don't believe it. Wrapped 24, for putting in the refrigerator, happy days, it looks like you had fun there. Thanks, Sunny B. Yes, I did have fun making them. Wrapped 24 gel, put Coleman's mustard in the fridge, WTF. Yeah, I keep mustard in the fridge once it's been opened. It's easier to spread. I'll keep looking at it now. It's a good job it doesn't smell bad, wouldn't it? Charlie, you should have got some cases from it. It'd been easier using the ramekins. Yeah, I couldn't get to the shop. Spraying the pictures, put, cut those nails. You're not in retail now. Get them off. And I replied, well, where things are going, I might be. I'm so good that flap hadn't flipped up and then the bed pooed, because otherwise I'd have had bed poo on my face. And it really has smudged everywhere as well. And hang on, it's so windy that if I get out this tent, the tent's going to blow away. I'm going to wash it off. Charlie, yes, so I can't cut the nails, but I did. I might be, could be, back in retail again. I didn't want to be. Next video is 2020, 2 meter social distance. Oh, this was a test because apparently you can do premieres on the YouTube now. But I want to show how it worked. Rebecca Trafford put, OMG, I actually joked about this the other day. You did it in the legend. Anyone moans how I'm dealing with it. Otherwise, I'd be panic stricken and crying all the time. I have an anxiety disorder and this sort of thing doesn't help. Charlie makes me laugh. And I think it's amazing at getting us through things. Thank you very much. Yeah, I was just like spraying a bottle everywhere when I... So just put, I love this, Charlie. Thank you for making us laugh. We all need it. Someone got very cross about it, making fun of the current situation. And they started slagging me off in all my YouTube videos, calling me the T word. And, well, okay, then what was I supposed to do? I'll sit in a corner wallowing in fear? No, not going to happen. Humour will get us through the day. And laughter's the best medicine. Medicine. How is it meant to be pronounced? Is it I've always said medicine. You know, medicine. Not medicine. Very weird. I don't know why the pronunciation of that word's changed. I can't stop looking at it. It's right in my eye line. I think a pigeon's given its verdict on my YouTube videos. I'll have to ban the pigeon. Ban the pigeon. I can't believe it's splattered everywhere. I'm going to stop talking about it now, even though I can't stop looking at it. You see, every little click now. There's a bit on the roof. There's a bit of splatter. It's crapped all over my flipping tent, actually. There's splatter everywhere. If it's a wood pigeon, I'll be furious. You know them wood pigeons that go, over and over and over and over again at something ridiculous like 7 o'clock in the morning on your day off from work or school or something like that, and they just don't shut up. It's annoying. You should rugby tackle someone for bog roll, said Ben Stocks. the prawn mate has put better stock up in those pot noodles. Do you know what? Even now, I don't want any pot noodle. When I lived a month off of pot noodles, I can't believe I did it still. Right. Rich Evans. I felt like doing that when going to Tesco's today. Apart from the 2 metres, what part of 2 metres distance don't they understand? Was so wound up, one couple had three kids pushing trolleys too. One of them was only about 10. So 3 items per customer became 15. And it was clear from the conversation they were not shopping for anyone else, because my first thought was how nice it was to get the kids involved with helping others. Never mind everyone else who was making do with stretching out what we can to help the virus effort. I had half a rich tea from my dinner today, and we'll have the other half of my tea this evening. I don't think that's too lavish. Stay safe, my friend. Well, thank you very much, Richie Evans. Yeah, I know it is a bit annoying when you see entire families going out all together. It's just like, well, come on now, you know, calm down. Keep them all at home. You'll bring the stuff in and wash your hands and everything and stay safe. But some people choose not to do that. Did you just read time put? That's about right, lol. I can't remember what the video was now. 2 metres social distancing. Oh, yeah. yes. Oh, God, I really feel like I need to get a cloth and wipe this off now, because I'm feeling a little bit disgusted. I'm going to do one more video, I think, because... yeah, when I worked at, I'll do this video. When I worked at, then I'm getting a cloth and wiping my tent down. Pause. I said pause. Thank you. Right, comments. What's it doing? I've got the white screen of death. No! I didn't say go back, did I? Did I say go back? No, I didn't. I remember this now. I had a bloody bit of tissue stuck to my nose all the way through the video, didn't I? And I always check these things as well. I was so annoyed. I mean, I was going to... A part of me wanted to take the video down and redo it, but then I thought, oh, stuff it. I mean, I embarrass myself every day anyway. Why not just do it on YouTube? Ben Stocks has put, I've got lots of memories of that song, Xanadu. My granddad is a huge Illo fan, like me, and we used to listen to it when I was very young. Oh, that's nice. I've never seen the film Xanadu, I just know the song. Xanadu. And Laura's put, YouTube didn't give a notification. It feels so wrong being late to a video. Yeah, YouTube are going through one of their things again. The algorithm's playing up in it. Obviously, I'm very low down in it. And all the celebrities now have all discovered YouTube because they're all bored at home. And it's very irritating because now they're pulling all the people to their channels with their excellent lighting and well-rehearsed scripts being as fake as anything. And you're just thinking, oh, whatever. Rapture24 Jill put, they have started doing this new thing at the company where I work, where the interview is done by members of the team where the person will be working. I'm on one of the panel, and my team and I have sat in some awful interviews. One that sticks in my mind, the woman basically said, I'm just here for the money, as an answer to every question. That's a shit. Yeah, the reason why she did that is probably because she's probably a job dodger and has no intention of getting a job and just wants to live off the state. That's probably what it is. I think that's what that is. And I've been to them interviews myself. I've been sat in on a few interviews. rather, where they've just had no want for the job at all. They've got to go to the job interview to satisfy the dole, just so they can, yeah, it's, yeah. Because you're thinking, come on now, people can't possibly be this stupid or thick, but I can't stop looking at that mess. One that sits in mind of people basically said, I'm just here for the money as an answer to every question. Another one said she would just like to spend some time from her team as... What? Sorry. Another one said she likes to spend time away from her team as much as possible to draw a boundary between the roles. And a third one came up from Sheffield to Newcastle and claimed he would commute every day from Sheffield to Newcastle. That's absurd. Don't know why HR put them in for the interview. I also had one woman who kept looking at a watch. This was a 40k job and was more worried about the time. That's really rude. Probably another one who just didn't want the job to begin with. MJ Music has put, I didn't know about old 10 down BT. Yeah, it's because back in the day, all the phones was operated by post offices. And they all got bought except Hull, really. And there was a few others, but eventually they got purchased by other companies or whatever, like BT or like privatisation, whatever. And, but yeah, Hull's always had Kingston Communications. Tim's put, awesome content, bro. Thank you very much, Tim. Emily Dixon's put, the bit about Wales laugh. Don't worry, this Welsh subscriber is staying put. You never fail to make me laugh, thank you, Charlie. You know, I've never understood, you know, because I get... Right, because if you're not from the UK, we have a bit of banter between the different countries. So, Scotland and English and Welsh, and Northern Ireland. And, but you never really hear much banter between Scotland and Wales and Ireland. So it always seems to be for or against England. Probably just because it's the better of them, all of them. But, ooh, winding you up. But no, it's just one of them things. It's weird we have this banter between us. And some people take it really seriously, though. I think football's got a lot to do with it. And people were, like, really, like, staunchly... You don't get very many people overly proud to be English. Because... It's been, the word English has just been run through the mud so much. I mean, we get blamed for every flipping thing. It's just like, you can't blame everything on the past, on the people living in the present. It's ridiculous. And what our governments do, you can't blame the people who live in that country. But you voted for them. That makes no difference. It doesn't matter if you live in a democracy or in a tyrant-controlled state. You still end up with a leader of somebody you probably don't want. And people have been quite negative about Boris Johnson, but I can think of a lot worse prime ministers we could have had in this situation. And it's the same in America as well, in the US, you know. I think there could have been worse of people you could have had in the US as president. Still, I know, there is, there really is. You'll never get the prime minister or president that you want. It's always going to be like this, always. We are so far down the list, it doesn't matter what we think or do. Dave Dumps put, Charlie, have you been on the white powder? No, that was silly. Jan Brands put, I hope more and more young people see this video. I have many experiences you've had during my early working life. Please stand up for yourself and never forget where you came from. If you can bother, do a live stream. Subs would love it. You're generally human. I do try to do live streams, but especially at the moment, because everyone's on the internet, it's really slowing things down. And when everything was so normal, if you can say that, I don't know why, but it kept cutting off, didn't it? And a few people were unhappy because it kept cutting off and bits were missing out and it was getting really jittery. So I stopped. And Toronto Pictures has put, you have a crow hanging out from your right nostril. And I replied, I don't know. I was so annoyed. It goes after about 20 minutes. I get a bit of tissue and I wipe my nose. But a bit of that tissue had got stuck up my nose. It's good to wrote on the blue roll, wouldn't it? Otherwise I'd had a blue crow, which sounds like an unhappy crow. I might as well finish this now because I'm actually dreading cleaning this crap off my tent. Oh, God. I'm so furious. I should wipe it off now whilst it's wet, shouldn't I? Oh, God, I'm I'm dreading it so much. Let's just carry on. Tipping point, let's play. I played a game of tipping points. Aaron Sox has put, lol Charlie, who is a gentleman with the love of his flatmate? Chris Silver's put, is that posh lad Sherlock Holmes in it? Samantha Williams has put, love this Charlie, I was playing along and shouting out the answers, lol. I know, yeah, it was, yeah, that's a duet again, weren't I? Groovesy, oh hello, you don't comment much, but it's great when you do. You see, it's weird that, because I do get lots of viewers, but when people don't comment for a long time and I see your name, it's like, oh, you are still a subscriber. At 24:13, my favourite part with the duck. Who doesn't love a plastic duck? Left so much when the machine played up, especially at 30 minutes and 34. I know, yeah. It's so tackily put together. The problem with it is the little circle thing underneath the red moving shelf. It kept jumping from the weight, but it does that even with the tokens it's supplied with. It's just really shoddily put together. So I just put, great video, along with Sherlock Holmes. Robert Atkinson's put, nice video, found this very entertaining. Thank you very much. Jack O'Khan's put, can you do a games night? I'm hoping to do a Monopoly one. And Jan Brand's put, Cecil Terwilliger. Oh, so there was the best years of The Simpsons, weren't they? With Sideshow Bob and whatnot, and Cecil. And yeah, that's the comment for that video. I'm hoping I've read all your comments out, by the way, because I know that sometimes when I do it off of these, it doesn't get all the comments out, which is really annoying. My next video was USA to adopt the metric system in the 2020s. Of course not. And I commented so much in the video as well. Come on, comments. Jonathan Reyes has put, you know who you just made me think of? Sloppy Turtle. Whatever happened to that guy? He was an American. Yeah, what happened to Sloppy Turtle? Where did he go? Did I offend him? I don't know. Sloppy Turtle I hadn't seen for ages on my YouTube comments. Don't know where. See, this now says it's got three comments and it's only loading two. And one of them comments was man. So whoever the missing person was, I'm sorry. I hope it won't stop it. I'll be furious if it was. But then I could always come back to the comments another day, couldn't I? Cream Eggster Skelter. I got some cream eggs and an egg slard thing. But instead of using normal eggs, I used cream eggs. Because why not? And blah, 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 blah. Blood Honey's put the lockdown content I needed. Thank you very much. Yeah, it's because what I did was I put it to some nice relaxing music, didn't I? Which was nice. I knew that people would like that because that music does get a lot of people commenting on it. Elizabeth and May Warren put, I'm not a big fan of cream eggs, but this was so fun to watch. I'm not a huge fan of cream eggs. I like them very much, but I won't go mad for them. But I just want this to make a good video. Big Joe Angels put, that's an exact model of the DNA helix of the Cadbury cream egg chicken. Aaron Sucks has put, classic content, dear Charles, reminds me of the Weeble Wobblies, Helter Skelter. Hope you are keeping well, dude. I remember Weeble Wobblies at primary school in reception class. Aaron Sucks has put, they used to be made of a glass and a half of milk. Now it's a glass and a half of sugar and of aspartame. Go easy on them. I know, but once they're in the house, you do tend to scoff them a bit. Raymond Vares put, Pat here, not Ray, of course. You're going to have to keep putting that, Pat, I'm sorry, because I will keep reading it, I'm sorry. While I have the time on my hands, I might set up my own account to avoid confusion. This is just gorgeous, Charlie, a work of art. I don't know where you get your ideas from, but please keep them coming. The eggs have definitely got smaller, haven't they? Enjoy putting them away. They have. They tried saying, didn't they, that, oh no, it's just because you've grown up. They definitely aren't. And I keep watching, like, old TV programmes, especially, like, old versions of classic Coronation Street and stuff like that. And you see the sweets in the background of, like, Rita's shop. And you're thinking, ooh, are they bigger than what they used to be? You know what I mean? And like, you're looking at the sweets and foods in the background. And, yeah. I was thinking the other day as well, you can time your life by what you call certain characters in Coronation Street, such as the characters Gail and Rita. Because they've been in the soap for so long and they've married so many times. I think Gail has married 6 times in Coronation Street. 6! You know? That's Elizabeth Taylor. I think she married 6 times. You know what I mean? If you knew somebody in real life who had married that amount of times. But yeah, so what I still call Rita though, because I haven't watched Coronation Street in a very, very, very long time now, well over about 10 or so years, but I'd still call her Rita Sullivan, and Gail, I'd still call Gail Platt, even though Gail has married a few times since, and even she married that lunatic murderous killer, what's his name? I've forgotten his name now. He tried killing them all by driving into the canal. Not Brian. I've forgotten his name. Well, anyway, she was married to him, didn't she? But I still call her Gail Platt and Rita Sullivan. Matthew Humphreys put, "Hi, Charlie. Cream eggs going round and round. I like cream eggs. Do you?" Yes. JJ Sweetan put, "No, that is cool." It was really good to do as well. I was really glad when I first put them in and it worked. Because I thought, oh, they might get stuck, or they might fall through, or they might be too small or too big or something. Sonia's put, "There is no shortage of Cadbury's cream eggs there, then." Sonia, I've got so many cream eggs now, it's ridiculous. Anyway, yes, so that's all the comments from that video. I think, yeah, this is the last one. Make it yourself. Hunter's chicken. I cooked some of my own Hunter's chicken. It was blooming delicious. And, Jonathan Rios has put, "At 2:06, is the camera reverse in the image? Are you really cutting with the knife with your left hand? I'm unfamiliar with Hunter's chicken. Is it really like barbecue sauce, like you said?" Yeah, it's like a smoky barbecue sauce. I replied to a lot of these comments already. And but yeah, I'm sort of dual-handed. I'm not quite ambidextrous, although sometimes I say I'm just a We'll show off. But just to say that I know that I can say the word. No, I'm not quite ambidextrous because I'm not really good at writing with my left hand. But I just pick and choose which hand. I don't pick and choose. I just go to something and use it. Such as a pair of scissors, for instance. Because scissors are a bit of a pain and you have to be either right or left-handed, I do cut with my right hand. But if I pick up a pair of scissors with my left hand, I've got to remember, oh yeah, they'll only cut with my right hand. Does this make sense? When I eat, I prefer to eat with the fork in my right hand and cut with my left hand. Sometimes I have a bit of a change and sometimes I don't. When I'm eating with a spoon, left or right, you know, because they're a bit universal, aren't they? It don't really matter as much. And I'm weird. I don't automatically right-hand anything. Sometimes I have to tell myself, oh, this will only work in my left hand, or this will only work with my right hand, this will work better in my left hand. For instance, pencil and ruler, from if I was drawing lines on anything at school, I think that. But when I was at primary school, even in the late 80s, early 90s, you'd still get teachers telling you it was wrong to use your left hand. So I think that's where it's come about. I think it's something like a half-learned skill. Half learned in the fact that maybe I was meant to be left-handed all along. I mean, my handwriting's atrocious anyway. But maybe that's what it was. Maybe it's a half-learned skill, because maybe I was always meant to be left-handed. Mark's put, "That looks fantastic. Will you come and make it in exchange for 6 bog rolls?" No, I will not, because I've got plenty of bog roll. Sprano Pictures has put, "Shave your head and leave the beard." Do it! Oh, do you know what I might do, just to shut you up, Sabrina Pages. I'm joshing. I might do it, actually, and show you how stupid I look. It doesn't suit me. I hate it. I did it once, obviously, off camera, and it just felt weird. This has never been as long as it is, and I'm actually, it's really nice just to, you know, when you're just watching TV or if you're bored, it's just to do this. And then all them stupid statistics come out where people say, "Ew, do you know beard contains all these germs?" Yeah, if someone doesn't wash properly, it will be dirty. But I'm clean. JJ Sweet Sam's put, "Sounds good, mate." It's really, really good. Elizabeth M.A. Warren's put, "We've had Hunter's chicken loads of times. It's gorgeous and easy to make. I think the bacon, with the bacon, it's a bit like pigs in blankets." Exactly, because you're just changing the sausages to the chicken, aren't you? I'm not a big fan of bacon, but I love eating chicken. It's my favourite meat. Great video. Yeah, the thing is with the bacon, you've got to get good bacon front as chicken. You can't just use your standard bacon. It's got to be some sort of fancy smoked or honey cured or whatever. Just get some good bacon. It's got to be really tasty bacon because it's not just a flavour you're adding. It's the whole part of the meal. So it's not just, it's the texture and it's the flavour and the smell and the luxurious. I'm salivating already. and that's all the comments, I think. Yes, it is. Well, thanks very much, everyone. Thanks for watching. Please grasp bell and let me know in the comment section down below. Anything you want to know. I am now going to, clean the flipping tent and edit all this together. Thanks for watching. Grasp bell me. Bye. Look at the state of that. Look at it. It's a good job I've got some Dettol wipes. It says it's got no bleach, no odour, no whatever. My tent's blown away. But yet it still kills 99.9% of bacteria and viruses. Well, I hope it'll get rid of this bird, but I'm glad it's gone on that bit, actually. That's quite a shot, isn't it?